no doubt they exploit fear of the other. There is no doubt at all. And that idea, of course, has got a long and very dishonourable history. A leading politician once said words to the effect that all a government has to do to maintain the support of the people is to persuade them that it is protecting them from a dangerous threat. He said it works in all countries at all times, and the person who said it was Hermann Göring. Think about the rhetoric that most people understand. If you say we've got a bunch of dangerous criminals and we're protecting you from them, and this does involve breaking a few eggs, people say, that's okay. That's okay. In the land that values a fair go, we don't think it's a problem to sideline the criminals and treat them badly. Of course, once you realise that they are innocent human beings who are not criminals and they're not dangerous and they're probably the enemy of our enemy, and therefore probably our friend, then it looks very different. But that's why the dog whistle message has been so powerful, and I'm sure that's been its purpose. And any country which recognises that it has been deliberately, relentlessly misled by its political leaders would understand that it's been served very badly by its politics. And I'm afraid that's where we are now.